books. Okay. So these are all of Charlie's books on the shelf.
Yes.
Is that like your bedroom?
Yes.
You've got some books on your shelf?
Yes. Yes.
Reading.
It's
great,
isn't it?
Yes. I love reading.
Once upon a time, there was a boy called Charlie Cook who curled up in a cozy chair and read his favourite book about a leaking pirate ship that very nearly sank and a pirate chief who got the blame and had to walk the plank. Can you see?
Yes.
Are you going to see? The chief swam to an island and went digging with his hook. At last he found a treasure chest, and in it was a book about a girl called Goldilocks. Can you say Goldilocks?
Goldilocks.
That's it. And three indignant
bears.
Good. Who cried, "Who's had our porridge? Who's been sitting on our chairs?" Good. They went into the bedroom and Baby Bear said, "Look, she's in my bed, and what's more, she's got my favourite book." This book was about a dragon with a fearless knight. Wait, I'm not ready for a fight. You must hear this one first. And then his armor clanked and shook.
Ho, ho, hee, hee.
Can you see the dragon?
Yeah.
He's laughing. He read aloud a joke he'd found inside his favorite book about Rowena Reddit, a very well-read frog, who jumped upon a lily pad and jumped upon a log, then jumped into the library that stood beside the brook and went Reddit, Reddit, Reddit as she jumped upon a book about an oak tree full of birds. Each bird had built a nest. Can you see the nest?
Yes.
And they had a competition to see which one was best. They chose an owl to judge it. And the winner was a rook, whose nest was lined with pages from his very favourite book. Good. About a girl who saw a flying saucer in the sky. Some small green men were in it, and they waved as they flew by. Can you wave? Wave, hello. Hello. Wave to the aliens. Can you see the aliens?
Yes.
She tugged her mother's sleeve and said, "Look, Mum, what I've just seen." But Mum said, "Hush, I'm trying to read my favourite magazine." Magazines. About a wicked jewel thief who stole the king's best crown, but then got stuck behind some sheep, which slowed his car right down. The king got on the phone, and soon the cops had caught the crook and flung him into prison, where he read his favourite book about a greedy, what's this?
Crocodile.
Who got fed up with fish and went on dry land to find some other kind of dish. He went into a bookshop and he there grew even greedier while reading on page 90 of a large encyclopedia about the biggest birthday cake the world had ever seen. Can you see this cake?
Yes.
Wow, he didn't go to blow all the candles. A team of royal cake makers had made it for the Queen. The cake was so delicious that a famous spaceman took a slice of it to Jupiter. He also took a book. till morning, then she found a shady nook and put her head back on again to read her favourite book about a cosy armchair and a boy called Charlie Cook. And that's it. Did you like it?
Yes.
Did you see how one book went to another book and then another book and another book? Mm. And you see here all the stories?
Yes.
What are these?
The bears.
That's right, the three bears from Goldilocks. And this is the
pirate.
And there's the
frog.
That's right. And here, who's this?
The king.
That's right, the king. All the stories together. And that's it, we're back to the books. Should we say, yeah? Is it quite difficult? Is it a bit difficult to understand? It's a very long book, lots of